Right, here we go. Professional debut here for Jackson Hume. He's in there with Naheem Chaudhry. And I'm looking forward to this because I've not seen him box before, even in the amateurs. And I'm joining the commentary position by Dan Murray. And Dan, this guy has brought a lot of people here from Blackpool to support him. It's a great atmosphere.
Yeah, just listen to that. I mean, there's a couple of coaches outside before. I was wondering who they're for.
Yeah, yeah.
I think we know now.
I thought that was for you, mate. I thought it was all your fans.
In my dreams.
You know, to have this much of a following on your first fight, there must be something special about this kid. I love his nickname as well, the Jackhammer. So let's see if we see some Jackhammers tonight.
Yeah, he's started very well. He's moving well and looks quite sharp as well.
Yeah. Very purposeful, a lot of ambition.
Yeah, obviously the debut, he's going to have a few nerves and that, so hopefully he starts to settle down a little bit.
He looks a very sharp and crisp puncher, doesn't he?
He does, yeah.
Put a nice little combination together there.
Yeah, put his shots well together.
I think you're probably right in a way. He does look a bit eager at the minute, doesn't he? And he looks quite nervous, but I think when he settles down, some of these shots and plants his feet. I mean, these shots look good.
Yeah, you can forgive it. It's his debut. He's going to be quite nervous. He's going to want to put a show on for all these fans.
Now, I always love seeing new fighters we've not seen before.
Yeah.
It's always really good, you know, commentating on these, seeing them. And I'm liking what I see so far. I like his ambition. I like his sort of aggressive nature.
Yeah, he means business, don't he? I like his head movement. He's moving his head well. He looks quite sharp. Looks quite light on his feet as well.
Now, you like the movers and slicksters.
I do. I like the fact that he's changed the angle. He's changed the angle quite well. And he is impressive. He looks to go to the body. And like we saw in the early fight with Ryan, it can have a great effect on your opponent.
You know what? He's got a touch of the Josh Kelly about him. You know when Josh Kelly first come on the scene?
Yeah.
He's got a little touch of him, the Josh Kelly, yeah. I do like what I'm seeing.
This kid with time as well, he'll get better and better because at the minute you can see he's still got a little bit of the amateur style.
Yeah.
When he slows down a bit more and gets a little more composure about his style.
And Chaudhry's actually doing quite well to just sort of
weather
the early storm, really. Doing the right things here. I mean, tying him up. I mean, he doesn't want to, you know, start holding too much, but he is tying him up and doing the right things to survive.
Yeah, but that's all Chaudhry can really do. He can't really engage with him, so he needs to try and spoil it, tie him up and stuff. But it's very, very, very difficult against someone this sharp and someone who's this good at moving. Nice. He's got a very nice array of shots.
He does, yeah. Okay? Puts them together nicely, doesn't he, as well?
Yeah. I think you can already see as well with Chaudhry. I think some of these shots are taking a toll. I don't think Chaudhry fancies this too much.
See, this is where it could be dangerous. You know, when the pace slows down a little bit there, just as I say that, he tags him there.
Yeah.
When the pace slows down and he's able to plant his feet properly and set them.
I think Chaudhry in that round, I think he's feeling it a little bit. He was very quick to go into the back foot towards the end of the round.
Seconds out. Round two.
Here we go, round number two. Jackson Hume on his debut, and we're liking what we see, Dan.
Yeah, he looks like an entertaining fighter, doesn't he? He looks very eager. He's definitely trying to put a show on, but looks like he's got a very good selection of shots.
To be honest, Dan, cut you off there, mate.
I was going to say, I like how he switches from head to body, how he changes the angle. I think he's a very smart fighter.
You know, with fighters that have a big following, they often do get drawn into fights more often, and it is hard. It's a hard skill to learn to discipline yourself, you know, and shut out the crowd sometimes, isn't it?
Yeah, I always feel that when a fighter's in there, I think there's no place for emotion in there. I think you should be using your head. I think you should be using what you've been practicing in the gym. And sometimes when you sell a lot of tickets, when you've got a big following, I think what happens sometimes is you land the shot, the crowd go crazy, you start fighting on emotion, you start getting dragged into wars what you don't need to be involved in.
Some nice head movement there by Naheem Chaudhry. He got out of the way there of the right hand, you know, and span off quite nicely.
He actually landed a nice shot of his own.
Yeah, and he's starting to jab a bit more as well now. he's not just come here to lie down, and I've got to respect him for that as well.
Yeah. Nice right up to the body there. Putting his shots together well, nice.
It's one of those fighters, you know, that's going to be an exciting fight.
Yeah. Be interesting to see if he's got any power.
Yeah.
I think that'll be a big determining factor with his style. If he's got power, you can see him going a long way.
Well, of course, that develops with time and all sorts. I mean, he's young. It develops with time, and I got a feeling when he just settles his style down a little bit, I think he is going to be a hard puncher.
Yeah. I think Chaudhry's feeling it. He's in the ring there. I think Chaudhry's just happy to kind of go on the back foot.
Yeah, he doesn't want to be showboating too much like this, though.
Yeah, he doesn't want to be engaging. Chaudhry, like what he did in the first round, he should be close up. He should be trying to spoil it. That was a lovely body
that
shot.
That was a lovely shot there. Set it up there with a nice little sidestep as well. Chaudhry wants to work on the inside.
Yeah, a little bit of inexperience there.
Yeah.
From Jackson, should be tying him up on the inside or doing his own work.
Now the pace has slowed down here a little bit, so we'll probably get to have a good look at his his fundamentals.
Yeah, he's settling down. Just want to see that jab keep coming out. With the first fight, there'll be so many nerves and so much adrenaline. Is that what we call it?
Okay, round three of Jackson Hume's professional debut, and we're liking what we see so far. And Dan, just going back to the fact that it's a pro debut, I mean, when you had your first fight, I mean, what was going through your head? And, you know, what sort of things go through your head on a stage like this?
I think nerves, I think you've got to kind of try and control your nerves. And I think here for Jackson, he's obviously done it in the amateurs, and I think it's a big question now, can I do it in the pros? And I think basically it comes down to he'll just be kind of trying to reassure himself that I belong here, I'm good enough. But with my first fight, there was a lot of nerves. I didn't perform how I should have. Tried to go for the knockout too early.
Well, mate, you'll always be a knockout to me. Good little exchanges here going on now. This is a bit better. I like it when both men sort of exchange a little bit. Tried to step back right hand there, Chaudhry.
Chaudhry's got a good counter right hand. We've seen it a few times so far.
He switches as well. He's quite awkward himself, really. He's not a wimp, is he? I mean, he's, you know, at first, you know, it looked like it spells that the right hand could have been on the wall, but no. He's stayed with it, stayed with the pace.
Well, I think as the pace has dropped, I think Chaudhry's fancied it a little bit more.
Yeah.
He's felt a bit more comfortable. I mean, yeah, Jackson started off like an absolute rocket. He was coming out, he's throwing the kitchen sink, and I think the Chaudhry's a little bit overwhelmed with it.
But, you know, Hugh might be, feeling the pace a little bit as well.
Yeah.
He did go out off to a flyer, so you'll learn about this, though, won't we, Dan, pacing himself throughout a fight?
Absolutely. And like we talked about your debut, because of all the nerves, all the adrenaline and stuff, you are going to drain yourself quicker.
Yeah. That's a good
That's
right
a
hand.
That's a lovely right hand.
Nice right hand.
Cracker of a right hand, that.
Needs to protect himself at all times because, he's at danger of getting caught on a break here. But that was a beautiful right hand. Knocked his head back. Eye-catching. Placed well.
Just want to see, as the pace has dropped, just want to see him get working behind that jab a bit more.
Yeah, he's a bit like Amir Khan in the amateurs, but, you know, he threw, like, four or five shots.
Yeah.
And then the fourth and fifth shots were just sort of like throwaway shots.
Yeah. Because at the minute, he seems to be only throwing the jab when he's loading up the right hands. I just like to see him maybe use the jab to open Naheem up a bit.
I mean, mean, there's no doubt that he's winning the round. You know, he's looking good as well, and he's learning some invaluable experience here. He's not had it all his own way.
I think so. I think there's plenty for him to go back in the gym and work on.
Into the final round here, Jackson Hume making his pro debut against Naheem Chaudhry, and it's been a good little spectacle this, and you know, he's done everything he needs to do, you know, but there's also room for improvement, but that's great, because it's going to be a work in progress.
He's ticked all the boxes, but the yeah. fundamentals are there. I mean, he's very sharp, he moves well, you can tell he's got a good ring IQ. And looking forward to seeing him develop, to be honest. But just going back to like being at his first performance, obviously a bit of nerves and that. What about your first performance, Aki?
My first performance was in a place called Harvey Haddon in Nottingham. There's about six people, mate. I got battered. So that's all you need to know about that. back to Jackson Hume.
What round was it? Just
the second round.
Second round.
Going back a few years. I mean, he does pop out of that jab there, and he's obviously been told by the corner to work the jab a bit more, hasn't he?
Yeah, it's your most important shot. He's looking like he's starting to enjoy it now. And just as I say that, it's getting a little bit heated in there.
The crowd are loving this. It's brought a lot of guys here.
It's been an entertaining fight. Been a very entertaining fight. Because there's been parts of it that Naheem's really had a go.
Yeah.
And he's landed his own shots and that, but I think the quality just lies with Jackson. Nice, changing the angle again. I like it. Nice.
Yeah, he did it again there. He chambers nicely into that body shot, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's mixing his shots up quite well now.
Referee just stopping the action here. Is it take gone loose? Or what is it, a head? What was... All right, OK, unintentional clash of heads.
Yeah. Yeah, referee just having a little word with him there. Maybe tidy it up a little bit.
Some good work there against the ropes. Very fast hands.
Jackson landed a nice left up there.
He's got a lot of speed, hasn't he?
A lot of speed, yeah.
Nice flashy flurries he throws.
Yeah, moves his feet very well. I think he's got a very exciting future, this kid.
Yeah, I agree. Looking forward to seeing him develop.
Yeah. So obviously got a good man in his corner there.
Absolutely. In fact, just looking at his corner, he's got a good, very good corner. I think Scotty Cardle's in there as well.
Yeah, he is. I saw Scotty there.
Yeah, former British champion. You know, I'm sure. And, you know, former fighters in his corner. So I'm sure he's got the right backing and the right people behind him, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. It's good for him as well, because he can call on them guys. That's Scotty Cardle. He's got a wealth of experience. But it's a very good four rounds from there.
The referee has decided that by 14 points to 36, your winner is...
to watch.
Okay, we're here with the winner, Jackson Hume, who makes a very impressive debut. Hey, listen, you bought a few, haven't you?
Yeah, got half a Blackpool with me. It's the Blackpool boys making all the noise. No, it's good support. It's great to have everyone here and people behind me wanting to support me. I've got them putting a performance tonight. I didn't want to get a stoppage, but I didn't want to force it, make mistakes. My team are happy with that debut, so am I.
Well, you were in against an awkward opponent, and you actually came out of the traps very fast, didn't you? And
yeah,
you got very fast hands. I mean, you know, where have you sort of developed this? And tell us a little bit about your background.
Well, to be honest, I've only had 20 amateur fights, and I've been with Matty Ellis. I was with Frank. That's what I've got his name on here. His daddy passed away last year, and he's been good with Matty. He's been making me learn all different moves, being sharp, being fast, and all, learn about all the angles. And I went to a few gyms, and it didn't suit me. I know there wasn't space for me at some gyms. And me and Matty just clicked and it worked. Straight away, everything that he did, I wanted to learn. And it's just good, and that's why I'm improving.
Yeah, and I got a sense you're going to be in some exciting fights. You've got a very aggressive style, haven't you, and you like to get in the mix?
Yeah, I do like to get stuck in. I know I come in known for a bit of a war. I just like to go fighting. I'll fight anybody, do you know what I mean? I want to win things, maybe lightweight, and go up to a different weight. I want to do things people haven't done before, so we'll see what happens.
Now, for people who haven't seen you yet, on British boxing television, you know, when can we see you out again, and sort of where do you envisage fighting next?
Well, to be honest, beforehand, I heard maybe Steve Wood could be putting a show in Blackpool in October. But any shows, really, just whatever gets me out, whoever gets my name out there. You know, I want to be different from the rest, not just in the boxing, outside the boxing, you know.
Well, they call you the jackhammer, and you did land some jackhammers tonight,
yeah,
didn't you?
Did.
Any final shout-outs from you?
Just thank you to everyone who come to me. Scotty Cardo, Matty Ellis, they've done so much for me. Joe Cardo, his dad. I just wanted to get going so bad, and I just wanted to make sure everything was right, and it was tonight, so I'm buzzing.
Well, actually, talking about Scotty, obviously a former British champion there, you got a wealth of experience. I mean, what's it like training, you know, having Scotty with you?
It's been mint, you know, we've done loads around sparring, it's been good. I've enjoyed every minute of it, and I'm learning, do you know what I mean? That's what it's all about. I want to spar the best, I want to be in there with the best, and that's what happens, and that's how you improve.
Brilliant, well, we've really enjoyed your debut. Hope to see you again soon. All the best, mate. Take care.